Hi. I want to clarify the point of my YouTube channel. Basically, it's intended as a philosophical channel, but also to look at historical issues from a psychological perspective and to compare and contrast my own experiential sensations and draw links to various written texts and other artifacts in order to make sense of things and to educate people about difference. It's depressing and it's regrettable that what I'm doing is sometimes not understood on the intellectual level and in accordance with the amount of rigor that I try at least to bring to it. I've been working on this kind of a project for a long time, since about 1997. It began with trying to make sense of my life, and then I did go into a lot of academic texts. And believe me, if you want to know a little bit about those, then my bibliography is available online. I can provide the evidence. But that even what's written there is not the whole that I read. I've been a voracious reader and very, very keen to observe what's going on around me, how people are, what they're doing, how they react to things. And I do my best with that. And I don't claim to be wholly objective, but I am aiming to be as close to accurate in terms of the phenomena that I observe as I can. And but yet naturally, of course, because I'm me, it's going to be through my own lens, the lens of my own consciousness. All I can do is to try to keep some consistency with the lens and not try to bend the lens to make a different situation seem better or worse than they were. But it's always a lens. It's always inevitably going to involve some degree of Jennifer's subjectivity. Now, I want to want to I want to make a philosophy channel. I want to if possible, communicate my concepts. But it is not possible when people assume something about my psychology that's actually contradicted already in the videos or already in regard to the nature of history and the nature of different existing circumstances. So it's very, very difficult when people come along and they say, "Oh, here's your motivation," and they give me the wrong motivation and they say, "That's definitely your motivation." And if it's some kind of like a cliche or something like that, like some kind of idea that I necessarily have to be motivated by, I don't know, an us and them mentality is often mentally sensitive. People feel like I'm not inclusive and that somehow they feel like they're them and I'm us, and then I have all this power because I'm us and I'm going against them, and they're just them and I'm just us, and it's just painful, painful situation. But I'm only one person, and I can be disagreed with, but it has to be on the basis of not things that are assumed, but things that, you know, maybe I've said, or maybe some more substantial basis for disagreement, like something from a text somewhere, not just like an out of the blue assumption about what my motivations must necessarily be like. Because that's just not right. That's not respecting the level of discipline. And knowledge, actually, that I've developed over the years. And it is important to respect things like that, because if you disrespect somebody else's, you know, at the very least, intention to be rigorous and intention to be disciplined and intention to be knowledgeable, as evidenced by the amount of effort and work they've put in, then you're disrespecting those qualities in all of humanity, and you're degrading the meaning of those qualities for everybody and not just for me. So it really is important to at least understand my sincerity in what I'm trying to do. And I may not always be right in what I'm trying to do, but it doesn't mean that I'm doing something from a weird psychological motivation, not by any means. And just because others say it and the herd starts bleating something doesn't make it true either. The herd will bleat what it chooses to bleat. It's out of my control. I don't control them. And that doesn't mean that I think that they're a them that I need to sort of control. I just say I can't. You know, they're the them that I don't control. And I wish, of course, I wish that they wouldn't make the kinds of noises that encourage others to emulate. And then we have a real situation on our hands. Of course, I wish that. And so I do see that as problematic, but it doesn't mean I want to engage with them as any kind of oppositional force. And in fact, I'd prefer if they would not engage with me whatsoever, which is what a lot of my videos are saying. So I want to keep this as an intellectual channel, not dealing with emotional issues or psychology in that kind of conventional or stereotypical sense, like where, you know, sort of motivations can somehow suddenly be known because we all have the same ones or something, or for whatever presupposed reason, which I don't actually know. I want to keep this as a channel where we seriously discuss things. And if you think I'm wrong, then you bring some evidence and you say, this is why. And rather than saying, because it's something, you know, some weird psychological motivation, which is it's not it's not the weird motivation. It really